All right, look, midterms are about a lot of things, but at the end of the day, midterms are about turnout. So what is the GOP strategy? We see it at this point as to push fear and loathing. Will it work? Well, we're going to see. But here's what we know right now. We know how it works. Here's step one. If you don't vote, the scary people from the South are coming for you. That's what people like Fox Folk host Laura Ingraham says. Listen to this.
Your views on immigration will have zero impact and zero influence on a House dominated by Democrats who want to replace you, the American voters, with newly amnestied citizens and an ever-increasing number of chain migrants.
You see that picture? That's what they want you to think all immigrants look like. People laying on the floor, splayed out, not as civilized as you, different from you. Amnesty and chain migration, which is also called family reunification when it's used by good people like Melania Trump, and that's how she got her parents here, right? So it was okay for her, but not okay for anybody else. That's how you will be taken out if you don't vote. Example two.
There is an anger, there is a rage on the far left that is really frightening.
They have encouraged mob rule.
Mob behavior that we're seeing all over the country.
You don't hand matches to an arsonist, and you don't give power to an angry left-wing mob, and that's what the Democrats have become.
All right, you get what the main word there was? Mob, right? Now, you could think, this is silly. No one's going to go for the idea that there's a mob of Democrats. Listen to Senator McConnell, the GOP Senate leader.
Our base is fired up. We finally discovered the one thing that would fire up the Republican base, the virtual mob that's assaulted all of us in the course of this process, has turned our base on fire.
Wow, he's really embracing something this deceptive and divisive? And it goes further than simply Democrats. In true us versus them fashion, it's not just about parties, it's about people. It's about the rabid left, okay? Like who? Well, like these women, like the vicious women who came out to share their stories of sexual harassment and trauma during the Brett Kavanaugh proceedings. These women, the same ones that confronted Jeff Flake on that elevator and made a difference, if you'll remember. Now, according to the GOP, these women are part of the liberal mob. Now, they're not as endearing as, let's say, the Proud Boys or the Confederacy kin that Republicans like to cotton to, but a mob? And if you're in, let's say, a really tight race, okay? It seems like the tactic is just go straight terrorist, like indicted Congressman Duncan Hunter, indicted yet somehow believing he has high ground because, according to him, the man opposing him is a national security risk. How does it make sense? Well, here's how it makes sense, all right? Hunter has a letter signed by three retired Marine Corps generals. And that letter says that his opponent, Amar Kampanajar, is a security risk. Now, this is part of Duncan's apparent effort to paint Kampanajar as a terrorist by referencing a relative of his opponent that was a terrorist. But that doesn't mean Najjar is. He's not even Muslim. If you're one of those people who are thinking, oh, it sounds like a Muslim name, maybe he is. He's not a Muslim, and you shouldn't even think that way. But no matter, as most of the terror threats in this country are, they're not from Muslims either, so it's just not a way to think. But what should you think? Kampanajar is a 29-year-old Christian. He was born and raised here, and he held a security clearance while working in the Obama administration. He responded to this by calling the letter pathological. Fear and loathing and arguably lying. Quite a strategy. But in a period of turbocharged toxicity, is it the way to get GOP faithful to the polls? We will see.